Hello, my dear students. Now we are having next question. Question number 25. Figure shows a circular wire loop of radius A carrying current I and place perpendicular magnetic field B. Okay. The first part, consider a small part DL of the wire. Find the force on this part of the wire exerted by the magnetic field. And the B part of the question is that find the force of compression in the wire. Okay, so in the first part we are considering a differential part. Okay, this is our current carrying loop, and this current carrying loop is placed in magnetic field, which is into the plane of this paper. Okay, and this I current is flowing. So the direction of, now we are considering a differential part, is the differential part DL. Okay, so this is the direction of differential part, and if you want to find the differential force on this differential part, we can use I DL cross B. Okay, so to find the direction of this magnetic force, you can use the concept of cross product, or you can use Fleming left hand rule. What is the Fleming left hand rule? This is FBI. Okay, this is the direction of magnetic field, which is into the plane of paper. This is the direction of current, which is upward. Okay, so the direction of force will be towards the center. Okay, so the direction of force will be this F, this DF towards the center. So you can write this direction of force, this DF, that is differential force, is equal to I DL into B, and the direction is towards the center. The direction is towards the center. Okay, now if you are talking about part B, find the force of compression in the wire. So this is our wire. Okay, a circular loop is there. This is a circular loop. Okay, and I current is flowing in this wire and is placed in magnetic field B. It is given in the question. Now we are taking one differential part, as already we have taken in part one. Okay, so this is our differential part. Okay, this is our differential part, and this differential part is making angle, let us consider d theta. This differential part making angle d theta on the center. So we can divide this differential part into two equal part. Okay, so these are two equal part. And the direction of force will be the tension. Direction of force, that is the tension, will be along the tangential direction, like that. Okay, tangential direction. Okay, now if this T and T, okay, we can divide, we can resolve into two perpendicular component. One is the horizontal component. So this horizontal component will be T cos theta, will be equal to T cos theta by 2, T cos d theta by 2. Okay, and it is also T cos d theta by 2. So because this angle, if this angle is d theta by 2, so this angle also will be d theta by 2. Same as it is in left hand side, this angle is d theta by 2, so this angle also will be d theta by 2. So this horizontal component will cancel out each other, and vertical component, which is the toward the center. Okay, so this vertical component is equal to 2t sine d theta by 2, and this will be equal to the magnetic force. What is the reason behind the tension? This tension is due to the magnetic force. So this 2t sine d theta by 2 is equal to the magnetic force, that is equal to I dl into B. Okay, into B. So here, if you are just taking very differential part, this sine d theta by 2, for very small angle, this sine theta can written as theta. So this sine d theta by 2 can written as d theta by 2. Very interesting concept is here. If you are taking very small angle, then sine theta is equal to theta. We can write it. So in this expression, this 2t sine, at the place of sine d theta by 2, you can write a d theta by 2. okay, because this angle is very small, you are taking differential part, very small part you are taking, is equal to I dl into b. Now this dl, that is arc, is equal to radius into angle. Okay, is equal to radius into angle. In this case, radius is given as a. So this dl can written as a into d theta. So now we are replacing this 2 will cancel out. This t into d theta is equal to I, and dl can written as a into d theta into magnetic field b. So here d theta also will cancel out, and you will get this tension T is equal to IAB. Tension T is equal to IAB, and this is the tension, that is the compression force in the wire. Okay, this is the compression force. This is the compression force inside the wire. So very easily we can understand this type of question so many times ask in different type of examination. So this concept you have to take care very carefully.